I'm a big giver. Why am I a big giver? Because I'm a Churchill giver, a pastor. Amen. Amen. I believe that you, when you give, you always have to give. Right? The Bible says if you want to give, you shall receive. And this is an example of how big giving is the thrust of this ministry. Y'all didn't have to pay anything. The information, I think I was maybe Rose and I, we were talking to someone else, maybe it was Brother pointed out, we were talking about how much this is worth. Like you, these type of workshops, you pay $300, $400 for, right? Your assessment, right? This is a wealth of knowledge that we are receiving tonight, which actually, and I see Sister Melinda, who leads our Agape team, which kind of coincides with what we do here, right? We have workshops here every quarter, right? Whether it's on financial training, whether it's on how to write, not succession, but how to write, bills, and information on purchasing mortgages and stuff like that. All that stuff is free, right? This upcoming fifth Sunday, our pastor is going to be giving away $1,000 to a member. Y'all should join. A tithing offering giving member, right? And so I said all that to say that I thank God that we are part of the ministry and that life is able to share this with the community, right? And share this with people that would normally have to pay for it. And I think that's a big thing. All right, so now that you are warmly welcome to life, amen, I'm going to welcome Miss Kimberly Williams Bookert. All right, I can't say that last week enough. I can't say that last week enough. Just a few things about Kim. For those who do not know Kim, I said this last year, so those who were here last year, just entertain me for a little while. Kim and I grew up together. We were in Children's Church, Youth Choir, Sunshine Band, all that kind of stuff. We terrorized Kim and her sister Tina. We terrorized church people when we were growing up, kicked on them, laughed at them, and all kind of stuff. So, yeah, we were bad. But I said this, and I'll sit down. I said it last week. One thing about Kim, when we were growing up, and even when we became young adults and stuff like Kim, always had money. I said this last week. She always had money. So when I didn't have money, I could always go to Kim to get money. Leech or whatever it is. But she always had money, you know what I'm saying? I needed a sandwich, you know? I was in college struggling. Call Kim, I need $1 or $2 to buy me $1 or $2 McDonald's chicken sandwich. So she always had money. Kim, I don't know, money just seems to come to her. And I think that speaks volumes to her as a person and also to her as capable of doing this class. And so without further ado, if you will, put your hands together for Ms. Kimberly Williams. Yay!
So we have to figure this out. You told me it's not supposed to start until like 45. And then the doctor's like, no, it might be a little earlier. We're going to struggle. And it is truly because of that, okay? So, yes, thank you so much. I summoned this for a thing. So did everyone have a good week? Do we have any success stories from the week of anybody learning anything fun or new or finding anything else about their credit? Yes, would you share?
When I tell you I have shared with everyone, I have literally shared with everyone. I went home and I called a couple of people, but one of the greatest things that I learned, because knowledge is so powerful, and I love to learn stuff from everybody. Mm-hmm. That part about when you said you had something on your, you had a collection, mm-hmm. and you was going to leave it right there.
Yeah.
I thought that was really fascinating because, you know, most anybody else would tell you that, but when you gave a reason why you did it, it literally made sense.
Uh-huh.
And
that's awesome.
I thought that was an awesome tip.
Good. Anybody else? No? Well, I learned something new this week. I had great successes this week, so I was pretty excited. I learned that the Attorney General for Georgia is on fire. So they are really cracking down on our lovely credit repair companies around here. I just called to get more information for our class, and I was able to talk with our Attorney General, Mr. Christopher Carr. He is very, very knowledgeable, and he knows what's going on around the city and what's going on with people's credits and all the little scams, and everybody that we think is legit, they're aware of it, and they're definitely cracking down on them. So that was quite interesting for me, and I would say it would be a win for the industry, because I'm in this industry, and it is hard to be in this industry for everyone to think that you're not doing it right because you can't get their credit repaired in 10 days, or you're not able to get it fixed in 25 days. Legally, you're not supposed to get it fixed in 10 days or 25 days, but you'll get a lot of advertising, and I'm sure you all see it around in the city. But be sure Christopher Carr, your Attorney General, definitely knows about it and is very much aware of these companies. He has a nice little list that he was willing to share of people that they are going after and looking, some of which I know. So that didn't make me feel a bit better. but as long as I know the way that I handle it and the way that we handle business here, but there are some things that a lot of them don't tell you. As Elder Bernard said, y'all have to help me with that because it's been Tookie Nuke or Bernard all my life. So,
please do not say it again.
Oh my
God.
That's what we know him for. So, y'all help me. There's no disrespect at all. So, if you hear me, Elder Bernard was saying earlier, I have always had some change or something in my pocket. And it's really the way I was raised. Not that my parents had money or anything. I think that's what meant me towards having money is because I didn't have it. So when I make it, I don't spend it all. I'm a hoarder of cash. And I like to have, I like to help people. It is so true. I'm not a flashy person. I can be if I wanted to be, but I don't have that desire to be at all. I would much rather prefer to help somebody else to move themselves up in the world. So that's where that honesty comes from, and that's truly from my heart that I want to be a help to you. It's not anything as far as what this class costs for. I went to a seminar in March, $4,000 credit repair seminar, and the registration itself in Orlando, Florida was $4,000. Excuse me, $3,800. So it was very close to $4,000, but it's worth it. When you invest in yourself, you invest in your trade, you invest in your skill, it comes back in much larger dividends. So you're able to do that. You have to pay your own flight, your own hotel, your own food. So, you know, once you invest in who you are or the things you desire to become, that's when it becomes beneficial to you. So I said that to say we're doing this for home ownership, so we wanted to make sure that you invest into who you are. We gave an assignment on last week. Did everybody get theirs done?
Awesome! Y'all are so good. I'm so excited.
I only received like three of them, though, by email. So I know there was a couple people that did send theirs in. If you were able to send it in, that's great. I do want to give a gift out. If y'all know anything about me, I love playing games and doing gifts and rewards. So I have some very nice investors that help sponsor this event for us, I guess for me to give out. So this one goes to Miss Denise, because she was the first one to get her completed paperwork to me. And she scanned it over to me. Denisha?
Denisha. Denisha.
Sheets, so you're actually taking your credit report and you're breaking